What's up, everybody? So the other day when the news broke about Bill Cosby being released from prison and not being able to be recharged with these crimes broke, Brendan Dassey's current lawyer, Laura Nyreiter, commented on the situation, which I made a video about, and now Stephen Avery's ex-lawyer, you would recognize him from the first season of Making a Murderer, Jerome Buting, has sent out a message as well. He actually quote tweeted Laura Nyreiter's tweet, and I'll read you what Laura had to say as well. Cosby was freed because he confessed after he was falsely assured that he wouldn't be prosecuted. Brendan and other false confessors remained in prison even though their confessions were also the result of false promises. Legalities aside, what's the moral difference? And in the video I did about this, I completely agree with Laura, but I don't think it's a moral difference. I think it's a money difference. It's a power difference. Bill Cosby is a rich American icon. That's how he was able to get freed, in my opinion. Power and money is everything. But Jerome Buting, Stephen Avery's ex-lawyer, states Cosby never actually confessed, but was given false assurances to make statements used against him. Brendan Dassey's case is morally far worse. No attorney, innocent, vulnerable 16-year-old, lying, false friend, corrupt cops, promises they'd go to bat for him. Sorry, that one was hard to read because he used a lot of abbreviations and I had to figure out what they meant quickly. But that's what Stephen Avery's ex-lawyer had to say, and I couldn't agree more with both of them. And again, I don't think morals have anything to do with it. I think it's money. I think it's power. I think it's fame and fortune. It's the same as O.J. Simpson, really. He got off because he was willing to spend every dime he had on his defense team. He had something like 8 trial attorneys. It's just absolutely crazy that power and money and fame can buy you freedom.